गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग।
मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गिविंग अटेंडेंस।
यस सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। यस, आर यू गोइंग थ्रू द स्लाइड? Invitations, instructions, and directions. These are the three lessons which I would like to go through today. I would like to revise.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Extending and accepting invitations, giving instructions, asking, and what is the title of the third lesson? Asking for directions and asking for and giving directions. Asking for and giving directions. This is the third lesson. Please go through the slide quickly. Read aloud, everyone. Yeah, I want to hear your voices.
Read the following conversation between two friends.
Read the following conversation between two friends and identify the
Okay, did it make any sense? Did it make any sense to you? Nobody is answering means no. Because you have not read it properly. Nobody has read it properly. How should a dialogue be read? As if you are speaking it. Hello, Gauri, how are you? Hi, it's been so long since we met. How are you? Any special occasion to coming up? Yes, my brother's marriage has been fixed. convey my congratulations to him. When is the wedding? It is on the 10th of next month. Here is your invitation. Oh, the marriage is on Sunday. Please do come. If you let me know your travel details, I will make the necessary arrangements. Thanks for the invitation. I will definitely be there. So this is how a dialogue should be read. Whenever you find any dialogue, this is how you have to read. Not, hello Gauri, how are you? It's been so long since we met. How are you? Any special occasion coming up? My brother's marriage has been fixed. Convey my congratulations to him. So that is just a duty. You are not, without making any sense, you read. Now, can you please read it again?
Yes, sir. Read the following conversation between two friends and identify the faces used to extend and accept the invitations. Mahi, hello Gauri, how are you? Gauri, hi, it's been so long since we met. How are you? Any special occasion coming up? Yes, my brother's marriage has been fixed. Gauri, convey my congratulations to him. When is the wedding? Mahi, it is on the 10th of the next month. Here is your invitation. Oh, the marriage is on Sunday. Please, Mahi, please do come. If you let me know your travel details, I will make the necessary arrangements. Gauri, thank you for your invitation. I will be there, definitely be there.
Yeah, so Yasmin has read it nicely. But how about the others? Okay, this is how invitation. The question which comes in your examination on invitations is, you have so and so thing, invite your friend to attend the have a party next week, invite your friend to attend that party. Write the conversation between you and the friend. Okay? You have your college day, annual day. Invite the chief guest. Write a conversation between the chief guest and you. That is how it is going to be, right? Now you have to write a dialogue like this. Then, please go through these expressions. Read these expressions. All of you, please read aloud.
Hi. Make as many meaningful sentences as possible using the expressions given. I would like to invite you.
Yeah, come on.
Would you like to come to a party on?
I would like to invite you. Would you like to come to a party on?
Thank you.
Or go with me.
Why don't you come on Saturday?
Yes, thank you.
Sorry. I would like to, but I may not. Evening, that would be. I'm afraid. I
would like to
join you for lunch.
That evening, that would be. But yes, I'm afraid.
I do.
Join
I would like
me
to,
for lunch. That sounds.
I'm unable.
Yes, we would. We could do. I would like to, but I'm unable.
Now, can you please read all again?
Make as many meaningful sentences as possible using the expressions given. I would like to invite you. Why don't you come?
Will you come?
Please do come.
Would you like to come to a party on?
Go out with me.
Can I invite you?
Yes, thank you. Would you mind coming to?
Yeah.
Yes, thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Why don't you come this Saturday? You come
off
Saturday?
Sorry.
Of course. Sorry.
I would like to, but I may not.
Evening. That would be, but I'm afraid.
But I'm afraid.
For lunch.
Join me
that
for
sounds
lunch.
Great. Yes,
sounds
we
great.
Could do. I would like to, but I'm unable.
Will you join me?
So these are various expressions to invite and accept, right? You must remember, not just please come. Please come. When you invite somebody, you can say, please come to my house to attend my brother's marriage on Wednesday. You can say, okay? But instead of that, you have various expressions. I would like to invite you to attend my brother's marriage on 13th of September. Why don't you come to my brother's marriage on 13th of September? Will you come to my brother's marriage on 13th of September? Please do come to my brother's marriage on 13th of September. Would you like to come to a party, I mean marriage party on 13th of September? Will you go out with me? This is, let me. Will you go out with me this evening? Or will you go out with me for the exhibition? May I invite you to attend the marriage function of our brother? Would you mind coming to my brother's marriage on 13th of September? Will you join me on 13th of September on my brother's marriage? See, these are various expressions which you can use. Yes, thank you. I would love to. Thanks. I am on my way. Why don't you come on Saturday? Of course, I would love to come. Sorry, but I can't come. I would like to, but I may not be able to come. Evening, that would be great. But I'm afraid I can't come. Will you join me for lunch? That sounds great. Yes, we could do. I would like to, but I'm unable. These are various expressions. You must remember all these expressions. If you want, you can take a screenshot. They are there in the textbook also. All these expressions are there in your textbook. But if you want, you can take a screenshot also. This is how you can invite, you can accept, and you can refuse. Okay? What is the title of the lesson? Extending and accepting invitations. Accepting and refusing also. Not just accepting. The title of the lesson is Extending and Accepting Invitations. But you can add extending, accepting, and refusing invitations. Okay? You can express your inability to attend. Right? Now, please keep these expressions in your mind. Now, I'm going to give you an activity. Yeah. Before this. Yeah, your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? Speak out your sentences. Here, understand the question first. What is he saying? What is the question? Speak out your sentences. Not a dialogue. Whenever such a question comes, don't write a dialogue. Don't write the conversation between two people. Here he is asking to speak out your sentences. Speak out means here you have to write your sentences. Speak out your sentences. Come write and speak. How do you accept the invitation? Yes, some expressions I have given. How do you accept your invitation? These are the expressions I gave you. You can go through them. How do you accept? Your friend has invited you.
Yes, thank you. I will definitely be there.
Yes, right.
The wedding. Yeah, your thanks. Sister's wedding.
Very good. Very good. Correct. Yes, thank you. I will definitely be there at your sister's wedding. All right. Now write the dialogue between your friend and you. Write the dialogue and then speak. I will give you 3 minutes time. You write the dialogue between your friend and you. Your friend invites you and you accept. Okay. Your friend invites you and you accept. See, the dialogue should be like this. If you want, you can go through the dialogue once again. Yes, are you going through the dialogue? How your dialogue should be
written? Yes, sir.
This is a model dialogue. Okay, you can start writing. After going through the example, you can start writing. Dialogue between your friend and you. Your friend invites you to attend his or her sister's marriage and you accept. Your friend doesn't invite you. There are some, there is some small talk. Small talk means, hello, Gauri, how are you? Hi, it's been so long since we met. Such introduction also should be there. Directly, she can't come and invite you. Yeah, how are you? How are you, Shreya? Yeah, I'm fine. So such small talk, I won't tell you. She invites you to her sister's marriage. Yeah, have you completed writing?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Jyoti. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Hema. Hello, Jyoti. How are you? Me. Hi. It's been so long since we met. How are you? Any special occasion coming up? Hema. Yes, my sister's marriage has been fixed. Me. Convey my congratulations to her. When is the wedding? Hema, it is on the 15th of next month. Here is your invitation. Me, oh, the marriage is on Friday? Hema, please do come. If you let me know your travel details, I will make the necessary arrangements. Me, thanks for the invitation. I will definitely be there.
Okay, now, you have been invited to a housewarming ceremony. What is housewarming ceremony?
House opening.
Gruha Pravesham. You have been invited to a housewarming ceremony, but you have some important work that day. How do you express your inability to attend the function in a polite manner? Write the dialogue between your friend and you. Okay? Your friend invites you to their housewarming ceremony, but you have some important work that day. Write the dialogue between you and your friend. You have to express your inability to attend the function. Now write the dialogue. One more important thing I would like to tell you is some of you are giving attendance on the next day or the following day or after 3 days. So that will not be considered. You have to give the attendance only in the class. It shows when you have given your attendance. Meer attendance ee roju ichcharu ee time ki ichcharu anedi vastundi 13th tariku 10th tariku attendance ichcharu. So you are not supposed to give like that. Give attendance only in the class. Has everyone given attendance?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now start writing the dialogue, and after 2 minutes I will ask you to read out your dialogue.
Sir, I'm Swati, sir.
Yes, Swati, start reading.
Invitation. Friend. Hi, Swati, how are you? Me. I'm fine. What about you? Friend. I'm fine. I am inviting you to a housing ceremony.
Housewarming ceremony.
Me. Oh, it's good. When is your housewarming ceremony? Friend, it is on 24th April. Me. Oh, okay, it's good. Friend. It is important to attend our housewarming ceremony. Me. Oh, I'm sorry. I have other work, so I can't come to your housewarming ceremony. Friend, why? Because I have an important work, so I can't
already attend. Already you have told her that you have some important work. Important work, okay. What is, how important that is? You have to tell your friend that it is more important than this housewarming ceremony. Mm-hmm. Okay?
That is very important. It is about my studies. Friend, oh, okay, your wish. Me, okay, thanks. Sorry for not attending to your housewarming ceremony.
Right, very good. Now, this one you have completed. This one also you have completed. Now, some more expressions, accepting. Thank you. Yes, I will be there. Of course, I would like to. Thank you. That would be great. Thank you. That sounds great. Thank you, but I'm sorry I may not come. Thank you, but I'm afraid I can't come. Thank you, but I won't be able to come. Hey, take the screenshot of. Take the screenshot. You have to write it in your assignment notebook. I would like to check all assignment notebooks when you come for exams. You must bring your assignment notebooks to college. Have you taken the screenshot? Your neighbor invites you to join him at a cultural program in your locality on a festival day. Write how he invites, write your acceptance, and write your brother's inability to accept the same. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, this is one activity you are supposed to do. And then, giving instructions. So, you know, when we give instructions, where do you find these instructions? Every day, instructions are needed every day. You have to tell your mother, you have to tell your mother has to tell you, come on, do this, do that, add sugar, yeah, add milk, close the door, open the window, don't go outside during COVID-19, don't go outside during lockdown period. So all these instructions, and whenever you find a brochure or a manual of a television or of a mobile, in that also you will find, do this. Charge your mobile completely before using. Did you find this?
Yes, sir. It will be in the book when we'll buy a phone.
Yeah, it is there. It will be there in that manual. So various occasions, every day, you will, many gadgets come with a manual. Okay? Now.
Yes, sir.
Read this quickly.
Read the following conversation between an examiner and the examiners and identify the instructions given. Examiner, have you received the OMR sheet? Examiner, yes, we have. Examiner, write your name and PIN in the space provided at the top. Examiner.
Okay. After that, take a pencil and fill the appropriate circles in box number 5. Examiners. Okay. Examiner. Open your answer.
One is examiner, the other is examinees. That means examiner is the invigilator. Examinees are the students who are writing that exam. Okay?
Examiner. Open answer block now. Check whether it has all the questions. Do not write anything in the answer block yet. Use
answer,
the
answer what black answer?
Answer book yet. Use the black sheet to do rough work.
Right. Instruction should be given step by step. Give all the relevant facts and do's and don'ts. Use simple and direct language. Use imperatives. Imperative means you shall do this. You have to do this. You must do this. You should not do that. Okay? They are called imperative. They must be arranged in a logical sequence. Logical order should be there. Open the box. First, open the box and put the battery. You must open the box. You should put the battery in the mobile phone. Then attach the charger to the mobile phone. Okay? Do not switch on the mobile phone. Just put it in the socket, charge it completely, and then switch on the mobile phone. Okay? The order, logical sequence has to be there. Instructions should be given step by step. Relevant do's and don'ts. You should not use the phone before charging it completely. Do's and don'ts. Okay? This is how you have to give instructions. And then you have to use such expressions. You go through the expressions. Read the slide. Yeah, I want to hear your voices, all the voices. 43 students are there in the class.
How to give instructions. When a series of instructions,
when a series of instructions are given, you expressions sequencing and starting, continuing, and finishing to make sure that they are completely
intelligible. The following list conveys some expressions used in instructions. Firstly, before you being.
Before you begin.
Firstly, before you begin, after that,
the last step is the first thing is the next thing is
the next step in the end.
Next
when you
start by further,
when you start,
when you have finished, lastly, to begin with,
finish,
and finally.
So you must remember all these expressions when you write instructions or when you give instructions. Okay. Firstly, before you begin, after that, the last step is, the next step is, finally, to begin with. All these expressions you must remember. Okay. You have to use these expressions in now. Give instructions to prepare a cup of tea. This is very easy. We have already done it. Now do this quickly. And as I told you, you have to use these expressions.
Firstly, before. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Come on, you can directly start because we have already done it. Yes, quickly.
Sir, I'm Swati.
Who is that?
Pushpa, sir.
Swati.
Not Swati. Pushpa?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please read.
First, take a cup of water in a
Take some water. Not why to take water in cup. Take some water in a glass. You can take in a glass, or you can, cup also you can use. Yeah, okay, doesn't matter.
First, take take a cup of water in a bowl.
Yeah.
And then light the stove. Mm. Place the bowl on the stove. Mm. Boil the water. Mm. Then add a teaspoon of tea leaves. Also add 1 teaspoon of also add a cup of milk.
Hmm.
Next, add a teaspoon of sugar.
Hmm.
Let it simmer some two to three minutes.
Let it.
Simmer, sir.
Hmm. What is the meaning of simmer?
Means take some time.
Right. Very good. Huh.
For 2 to 3 minutes.
Hmm.
Turn off the stove.
Hmm.
Finally, filter the tea into a cup.
Pushpa, are you reading your notes or are you reading from your textbook or are you telling on your own?
Sir, notes, sir.
Mari notes cheppadu kadamma swantanga cheppali.
Notes
lo swantanga rasnam kada sir. Notes lo swantanga rasnam. Okay, then it is good. Very good. Nicely done. So this is how you have to give instructions. Now, take this. Give instructions to wash one's face. Just a screenshot. Give the rules to be followed while crossing a road. Write instructions to withdraw money from ATM. So the third one, you have to do the third one. Write instructions to withdraw money from an ATM. Do you have ATM card, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Oh, those who have ATM cards, please write the third one. Those who don't have, please write the second one. Those who have ATM cards, write instructions to withdraw money from an ATM. Those who don't have ATM cards, write the rules to be followed while crossing a road. Okay? Quickly, 2 minutes. Only 2 minutes I will give you.
Sir, I'm Swati, sir.
Yeah, Swati, you are talking about ATM card?
No, sir. Giving the rules to follow while crossing the road.
Okay, now start.
Giving the rules to be followed while crossing the road. Hmm. Firstly, we have to see any vehicle is coming or not. Before we begin, we have to see whether how we are crossing the road. After that, we have to see and we have to cross the road. At last, finally, we should cross the road. That's all.
Okay, but we should means it is should is used to give advice, Gada. Only in the last lesson we learned must, should, have to. Now here, what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to give instructions. Should also, you may use should also, but it is not like this. You must do this. You must.
Okay, sir.
Before crossing the road, you must look both the sides to check whether traffic is there or not. And then you have to. Okay. Now you can begin again. Yeah, unable to hear you. Are you speaking?
Sir, 1 minute.
Okay. Take your time.
Hello, sir.
We have to understand that the instructions kaadu kada. We have to do this, we have to do that, and it is only an advice. It is not an instruction. You have to do that. You must do this. You should do this. Atla undali. Yeah, who wants to speak?
Sir, I'm Manga, sir.
Yeah, Manga. ATM or road?
Road, sir, crossing road.
Okay, right.
You must keep checking in both directions to make sure the way is clear. Yeah. And you must try not to cross the road from between parked cars or near trees and bushes, as driver may not see you. Yeah. And you must avoid crossing near a bend or crest in the road. And you must do not stick your hand or head out of the moving the vehicle.
Right. Very good, very good, very good, Manga. So you are going in a car, huh?
Yes, yes,
you are walking? You are walking? Are you walking or not?
Do not stick your hand or head out of a moving vehicle. It's, we are going in a vehicle, like car or something, bus. When we go...
Okay. Doesn't matter. You are going in a vehicle. Right, okay. One more person. Anybody about ATM? Some of you have ATM cards, right? Okay, then.
Sir, I'm talking, sir, about ATM.
Yeah.
First, we have to go to ATM. There will be a machine. We must type our PIN number.
You must.
You must type your PIN number and insert your ATM card.
No, you without inserting it. First, you have to insert, kada?
First, we have to insert our ATM card. Then we have to type our PIN number, PIN, and then we have to withdraw our money. Then we have to must withdraw our money.
Okay. Some more steps are there. You can write them also. You can find out from your father, or your parents, or your brothers, and write. Now you have to write instructions to withdraw money from an ATM also should be there in your assignment notebook. Are you noting down, everybody? Take a screenshot.
Yes.
And this third question should be there in your assignment notebook. These are some more activities. You have to practice opening an account in a bank. All of you have an account in a bank. So all of you have applied for bus passes. All of you have found words in dictionaries. I think most of you know how to prepare potato curry. Do you know?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now we have only 1 minute time. Can somebody quickly tell me how to open an account in a bank? You have already opened. You need not have any time to write it down.
For opening?
Yeah, opening an account in a bank. What should you do? You must first go
first
to the bank.
Bank account. We must have our Aadhaar card. We have to have our details of the area, present area where we are living.
Your address proof. You should carry your address proof and Aadhaar card along with you.
Photos. We have to check our bio.
You have to check?
We have to check our biometric. And we should take our photo.
Yeah, photo. How many photos are required?
8 photos, sir.
Yeah, you must take 8 photographs along with you to be submitted in the bank.
And you have to